We conduct biannual deer surveys to try and determine the density of deer that we have in the park. Well, it starts out, usually I do like a safety briefing, kind of a general description, you know, of how it works.
Just keep scanning back and forth with the spotlight as we go. It's like 5 to 8 mile an hour, so it's relatively slow. So you just scan with your spotlight back and forth. If you see a group up, say they're like at the wayside, you try and figure out, say, okay, there's a group of two there. You don't have to stop the truck right then. You just know that there's a group of two. If you can identify them, cool. And wait till you get perpendicular, so you want to be at a 90 degree angle with the truck or the road and where the deer are at, and then we'll stop.
We have like 25.7 kilometer transect in this park. We have seats in the back of a pickup truck that we'll set in, and the person will usually have a set of binoculars, range finders, and then they'll usually have a spotlight to count. So you'll just basically scan the woods as the truck drives. You know, we'll spot them, we'll try and determine if it's a buck, doe, fawn.
Seeing one known in 48.
And take the rangefinder and shoot the distance. As opposed to last year when we did this, it was colder weather, the deer were more active. I think it was more during the rut, so the bucks were more active, so we may have seen more deer last year. This year they're concentrated up near Oak Ridge. There's oaks all over the forest, but I think Oak Ridge, I think it's partly where it gets its name, is it's nothing but like a big oak flat.
Yeah.
I'm just a wildlife enthusiast and love wildlife.
Nine.
Just love sitting back and seeing deer. I'm okay actually with driving the truck. It's okay. I still get to see the deer, so it's just neat being outside and dark. But not many people get to ride through the park, you know, after dark, so it's something else that's kind of neat about it. Get to see the park at dark or after dark.